Well, like I said, the simplest loadout I could manage, and, well, just knockdown effective purely by the fact that it puts out that much damage with that few weapons. Well, that's your sniper for you. But we still have, well, the championship rounds to play against everything else. So, well, I suppose we're gonna go another round in our big scary assault mechs. Well, another few rounds. So, let's mix and match here. Since... Did Wyoming... Yeah, Wyoming walked out of that with no damage, so, I will use him first. Though everybody else is undamaged as well. So, we'll bring Musketeer into the Coliseum. And see what he can manage here.
The last game for the year in the Coliseum. This is Duncan Fisher, and Silesia is going crazy in anticipation. The Steiner fans aren't too happy because local favorite Ellie Niels lost her last five matches and won't get to compete in any of the championships. A real upset. But there is a ton of hopefuls and some real powerhouses left. One dark horse that a lot of people are betting on is rookie favorite Spectre. He slugged his way through each class of competition in this arena. He's earned a crack at the arena title. Way to go, Spectre! Not only is this an arena championship match, but it is the first of the season. A lot of times, the first championship is a good weather vane for who the big players are going to be in the grand championship. A good showing here can give a pilot that extra psychological edge needed to go the distance. It's going to be one heck of a game.
We going all the way!
Let's go!
Now we're gonna back up, you know, pretty cheekily into this archway. And make sure all the enemies target each other before we start cracking along with the heavy goss. Or rather, railgun.
Enemy detected.
Excuse me. Light mech. Oler. Stand still, will you?
A clean shot and another mech is rubble.
Well, absolute terror.
Target destroyed. Enemy detected.
Stole my... Oh, you motherfucker. It's Fei
Cheng. To keep track of in one of these games. You have 16
My vengeance will be now!
A normal game would be the star. Championship play is frenetic.
Daishi, let's have a ceasefire
Watching
agreement.
The best duke it out is
no, he's
treat.
Running.
And every one of... He went down because he didn't know who the key players were. You can never ignore your main competition. You can
Damn
be
it, Daishi.
In a nice duel, and that annoying tap from behind can be the last thing you feel.
I'm trying to achieve vengeance! Vengeance! Thank you, now he's shooting at him. You see, now he's got me. He understands my thirst here. Ow. Good! Sit down. Thank you, Mr. Daishi. Your death will be the least spiteful.
The field is clearing up a bit, and it has been a great championship so far. I'm sure that some are surprised to see Spectre still up and running. At this point, you'd think people would recognize that this rookie is the real thing. He's not just lucky down there, he is making it happen. He's also a bit of a bookie's nightmare. Anybody that put a mark on him for making championship has made enough money by now to change lifestyles.
Target destroyed.
I think I got that kill. Look at me! Look at me! Notice me, Alice Senpai! Thank you. Oh, damn it! Stop turning away!
Man, Spectre has got some good eyes. He certainly keeps nailing his shots tonight. Three down, all because they've been in his crosshairs, which is a very dangerous place to be.
If you would just stop for 5 seconds.
Target destroyed.
There we go. Now the nameless sun in the black knight. Well, at least I'm really efficient in taking out side torsos. If I had steadier hands, they'd be one shots. Wait.
Spectre, he's amazing. That's it, Spectre is now the champion of the Coliseum. From out of nowhere, I haven't seen a performance like this since Gross took the Grand Championship in 62. The sands are choked with debris, and only the best man is left standing. And today, that man is Spectre. The Grand Championship still remains to be played, and I know many of us are wondering whether or not Spectre is prepared to deliver one of the best rookie performances in Solaris history. Until next time, this is Duncan Fisher, live from the Coliseum, signing off.
And now I remember that I lost track of the amount of kills I got there.
Whoops.
Okay, well, Musketeer still is the standout of this entire escapade, I suppose. But, well, now let's move on to the other championships. Yeah. Let's see here. What I wanted to do before I wanted to do that, go to the free market and buy those assault lasers. Let's see how those manage. They do 10 less damage than the plasma cannons, but obviously they're probably going to draw less heat and be less stressing on the machine. Then again, Black November is a machine of extremes. So we will remove those. And, well, they are a fair bit lighter as well. We can actually put in more coolant pods here. We actually have space for additional coolant pods. Interesting. And we also have some more heat sinks. We up the armor at all, and, well, aside from the center torso, no. So, well, and just amp that into the ceiling. Alright, that's a bit more of a balanced machine. Coolant pods go into 3. Continuous at 2. Right? Okay, so we have 900 meter range with the continuous beam lasers, and 300 meter range with the assault lasers, which are a little bit easier to handle than the plasma cannons. But they only do slightly less damage. They do have reduced range as well, but they should be okay in an arena environment. In the field, we might have to worry. But let's go. So we'll bring you into the jungle this time, considering that the factory was okay. Let's see here. Wait, wrong mech.
It's Jungle Mania in Cathay. This is Duncan Fisher in the jungle arena for the last match of the jungle circuit. Today, people are competing for who is the arena champion, and the competition looks fierce. As expected, most pilots have come in their best assault or heavy, and they have spent a motherload on the best weapons C-bills can buy. We have so many key players here, I don't know where to start. It's anyone's game, and it's time to watch the action. Watch it right here.
Let's begin.
Action time.
Well, good thing there's a wall separating us from Mr. Alex here.
Enemy detected.
Let's see.
Enemy detected. Enemy detected.
Well, those function. Not too big on the heat drain, even though it is noticeable. Ow.
The field is filled with big names that have big guns. One of the new faces is Spectre, who's managed to secure a spot in this championship, even though it is his rookie year. He's become something of an... All it takes is one good shot. Another mech hits the ground.
All right.
I'm always amazed in these open-class championship games at what mech pilots bring in. And a lot of times, I'm even more amazed at how well they do. Last year, someone brought in a medium mech and lasted until the final 3. Not only is that extraordinary skill, but also major style points in my book. Most of the time, the big boys win this one, your assault and heavy mechs. But hats off to the lighter mechs out there.
Seems like we've got a very large engagement here. Also, a wrong button! I wanted to use the continuous lasers to hacksaw the trees away, but because I am retarded, I pressed 1 instead. Ah well. What do we got here? Let's size up. Oh, look, it's Fei Cheng! He goes down first.
That kid is on a roll.
I don't know if I got that kill, but oh well.
Target destroyed.
This Uziel is just sort of
the action down there
in
is
between
intense.
Us all.
We still have some names down there, but some have fallen by the way.
Ow!
Destroyed.
Oh. Excuse me! I'm walking here! Also, we're sitting in water now. We're now in the optimal area for Black November to project. Okay, maybe not. Maybe we can't oppress literally everyone. Ow.
Target destroyed.
Yow! I can't see because of the smoke. Wow! Black November, come on, bro. It's just something about the Warlord chassis. I don't know what it is, but it just seems to absorb fire. Or rather, not even absorb, attract fire like nothing else. It's got the same problem as the Pit Bull. So I suppose, I suppose we're gonna have to reassess our strategy here. Though I believe that we can try, I believe that we're not gonna get locked out of the championships like that. Yeah, you see, we're fine. Oh, wrong button. Okay, so, the assault lasers did their job, it's just that we took way too much damage before we actually managed to actually do anything. Well, we did do okay, it's just that, it could have been better. So, in the interest of making it better, let's bring ourselves down and bring up those plasma cannons. Since we do have the space for them, why aren't we using them? It seems that we need the extra damage output to survive. But the heat output is kind of terrifying. But in the jungle, at least, we're going to have enough to get us by. So let's try that again.
It's Jungle Mania in Cathay. This is Duncan Fisher in the Jungle Arena for the last match of the Jungle Circuit. Today, people are competing for who is the arena champion, and the competition looks fierce. As expected, most pilots have come in their best assault or heavy, and they have spent a motherload on the best weapons C-bills can buy. We have so many key players here, I don't know where to start. It's anyone's game, and it's time to watch the action. Watch it right here. Action time!
Alright, now let's go about this a little bit more intelligently.
Enemy detected. Enemy detected.
Mm-hmm. Please stand still.
Warning, fleet exceeding recommended level.
All it takes is one good shot. Another mech hits the ground. The field is filled with big names that have big talent. One of the new faces is Spectre, who's managed to secure a spot in this championship, even though it is his rookie year. He's become something of an item, and many people hope that this underdog can take the prize tonight. But there is some fierce competition out there. I'm always amazed in these open-class championship games at what mech pilots bring in. And a lot of times, I'm even more amazed at how well they do. Last year, someone brought in a medium mech and lasted until the final three. Not only is that extraordinary skill, but also major style. Not much you can do about it. That guy, that kid is on a roll down there. That last guy just got hammered.
Uzeal, I'm so sorry.
Level critical.
Whoa!
Shut down imminent.
Ah! Too hard. Too hard! Reboot! That Uzeal got caught in that explosion and lost both of his arms and overheated. Oh no. What a shame. I'm so sorry for your loss. Shooting for the cockpit is illegal, sir. You should probably watch it.
The action
down is this there is fucker intense. Again.
We still have some names down there, but ow! Some have fallen by the wayside.
Oh, you
the
son of a bitch.
Always have so many big names. That pilot's fourth kill. Amazing.
It's the Thunderbolt shit again. You never fucking stop, do you?
Target destroyed. Warning.
Sit the fuck down.
Level. Target destroyed.
I do like the plasma cannons, even though they are really hard to manage. They do generate a shocking amount of heat. It's like a flamethrower sucker punch. Just almost as good as LBX. But then again, they do more damage, so I suppose they are better than LBX. I suppose Black November does have some selling points here. Okay, so what are we dealing with here? A bushwhacker, who is apparently overheating in a bush. Okay, we do have 600 meters of range, so we can't actually engage this awesome from here. Just waiting for a clear...
Target destroyed.
Good. Right through his back armor. Okay, now. Bushwhacker. Dead!
Warning. Approaching critical heat level.
Mess fire! My bad! Have to be careful with that.
Down
no.
Warning. Damage critical.
Also, we have to be careful here. This is actually very bad.
Heat exceeding recommended level. Weapon destroyed.
Oh, great. We lost a cooling pod. We're not going to get more of those. Done.
It's Spectre time.
And we actually managed to stave off shutting down, too.
He swept the jungle. We have a new champion of the jungle arena. He's not some fancy seasoned veteran with big company sponsors. He's come from out of nowhere, and he is on a roll. And in case you're living under a rock, his name is Spectre. An absolutely phenomenal performance. I can't wait to see how this rookie does in Grand Championship. This is one announcer who is dying to see what comes next. Duncan Fisher from the jungle, signing off.
Okay, well, once again, I prove myself a master of heat management as I, I cheat with coolant pods, but we did lose a coolant pod in that whole mess, so that's rather unfortunate. Though we can get more of the small ones. Right? Right? Still have those in stock, right? Ah, fuck. Ah, damn it. I suppose that's another mecha trope for, Black November to be, handling around. It's coolant pods are lost tech, so as soon as it gets damaged, it's gotta limp with it forever, basically. That, it is an unwieldy beast. Well, I suppose we'll sort to that later. Now, we're going into the factory next, and Gunsmoke is gonna come with us. But, well... See, can we do anything with Gunsmoke?
Roger, control 3 hours. Starting salvage operation. Forward one. You're running out of...
Well... All things considered, we could start doing a few crazy things here. We have enough money. So let's see what we can really get in the ballistic category that really just knocks people over in an instant. Hyper AC-20s, those are really heavy, and they're 4 slots. We only have 3 slots on our ballistic arm, so we're not actually going to be able to get those in there. Oh, I suppose the UAC-20s might actually prove entertaining here. Musketeer owns the Gauss, so I'm not even going to really try there, but, let's go for alpha damage. These are 16 tons each. Can we get 4 of them in there? I wonder. Fifty-six tons. So, can we get all of these in here? No. Unfortunately, we're gonna be short one. That is unfortunate, and we do need the ammunition supplies, so unfortunately, we're not going to have the Ultra AC-20s, well, 4 of them at least. So, we'll just roll with the 2 of them. They do more than enough damage by themselves anyway. So, let's see here. Let's max out the center torso armor, just for our entertainment, really. And, also keeping us alive in the heat of battle. That is also a selling point. Alright. There's that. Now we have 20 tons to play with and for additional armaments. We need something with a little bit more range, so I suppose we could just jam a smaller assortment in there. Or we could go for the machine gun route again. The light machine guns are what we need. We need range. So, I suppose we'll go with that. They're a one ton each. And we don't need... They seem to have more than enough ammo in one ton for anything that we could possibly ever use them for. So let's rely on that. Hmm. 10 tons left over. That's rather unfortunate. Oh well. What else can we do here? I don't think there really is anything else. I mean, I suppose we can also make the machine faster, which would help with the UAC problem. But I think, in terms of ammunition, I think we should be alright. Since these do fire 2 shells at a time, let's make sure they have a little bit of extra ammo in there for a little bit of leeway room. That went fast, didn't it? And I suppose since we're going to be firing those weapons repeatedly, let's make sure we have some heat sinks in this machine. Some. Alright. Not sure what to call this loadout. Long-range machine guns and very powerful short-range guns. I'll think about it. Gibraltar seems to have the most alternate patterns or loadouts, as it's turning into Zoids rather quickly, but I have my fun. Alright, so. This should be good, I think. So now we go into the Factory Championship. I just want to see how high I can get the Davian number to go at this point. But, well, let's claim our spot in the Grand Championship, shall we?
And it is finally time! This is Duncan Fisher bringing you the last game of the Factory season. This is it. Tonight we find out who is the king of the rubble heap. It is an all-star lineup as the best of the best duke it out for total Factory domination. We have Sren Odessa, who placed extremely well last year and is one of the favorites for the Grand Championship. We've got Marcus Wilder, who unleashed a brutal campaign of terror in the Assault class this season. And there are plenty more where they came from. This is one game you don't want to miss. Let 'em loose!
Hello, Loki. Ow.
Enemy.
If you would stand still for just a moment.
Made it look easy. One more down.
That's one down.
Sren Odessa has been a name to watch in Solaris for years. She placed 10th in the 62 match, and she's been gaining ground ever since. Many believe that this is her year to finally take the title. Sren is one of those players who is a joy to watch.
Okay, good.
The Arena Championship matches are the real proving ground for the big event, the Grand Championship. Some of your real big names on the field have their attention divided. Sure, they want to win, but a lot of their focus is on everyone else on the field. How they fight, react, and deal with the unexpected. One mech pilot out there told me that they just want to focus on throwing some monkey wrenches at the new guy. 2 kills, not bad for a rookie.
3 kills.
And there goes Sren. It took a bunch of them to drag her down. Pretty good tactics out there. If you take out...
Come on, go down!
From Merc Jock to Solaris Jock, this Spectre is showing everyone how to take care of business. 3 kills on the board, and maybe some more to come.
4.
Destroyed.
I don't think I got that one, though, so I'll leave that one.
Destroyed.
This is the last championship of the season. Only one more game to go, and it has been a
destroyed.
Hello, gents. Fancy meeting you here. Mr. Dexter? Hello? Fancy meeting you here again.
He's on a roll. That's 4 for Spectre.
And... one more unfortunate medium mech to take care of.
Yeah. Victor is now the arena champion.
Thank you, thank you!
Bam, that is it. The last game of the factory season is over. And who won? Not any of the old favorites. A dark horse named Spectre. In an unbelievable season, he has won in every category in the factory and is now king of the rubble pile. There is still some more left of the season, and just like you, Solaris fans, I'm on the edge of my seat to see just how far this Merc rookie turned champion will go. This is Duncan Fisher, live from the factory, signing off.
Well, alright then. We took minimal damage, and we absolutely wrecked everyone that came across us. The UACs are finicky, but they do get the job done if you can focus them in hard enough. Now, do we unlock the Grand Championship right off the bat, or do we have to wait? Ah, we do! Well, I suppose this is it. This is the end of our Solaris career. And I suppose the most reliable machine that we could take into this whole thing is, well, frankly, Wyoming. And I'm not saying that just because I have special attachment to these machines, and Wyoming in particular. They're all sentimentally important to me, in ways that I will explain one day. One day. But, come now, old friend. Let us attain honor and glory once again.
The big game. Each game of the season, every single pilot who walks onto the field is aspiring for just one thing. Being right here, in this arena, tonight. This is Duncan Fisher, bringing you the Grand Championship. This is the match of the season, and tonight's match looks like it's going to be one that'll be talked about for years to come. We have old favorites, Srin Odessa and Samantha Coleman. We have new stars, Spectre and Nako Tayuma. We have watched them slug through everything that has stood in their way, and now they have one chance for glory. So now, here comes Solaris at its absolute best. Game time!
Excuse me, I'll back up really quickly so I don't draw that much fire. Excuse me. Bye! Excuse me? Also, well, I seem to have backed up into a wall. My bad. Let's let everyone get distracted.
Ouch, that one's gotta hurt. Looks like that's one mech for the trash heap.
We have an ally and a Medcat Mark II over there, so, well, I suppose we'll help him out. We can provide long-range fire support. That's the name of the game here. As soon as we actually see any of the people shooting at him, which doesn't seem to be... Well, come on, man. Come out of the shadows and fight. Oh.
If you're gonna try to dodge, it's best
Hello,
to dodge
Samantha.
Out of the way,
well.
Not into it. I bet that pilot's thinking, hey, how'd I get hit? With reflexes like those, he should expect it more often.
Well, I suppose the area's a clear- Oh my goodness! Fei-Cheng! Your bullshit ends here. You cheesed your way to the championship. Well, that PPC got stuck on a wreck. This shit ends
this
today.
Is it, the last chance for the year for these guys to strut their stuff. Looking out there is like a who's who of Solaris jocks. A few surprises, some veterans, and even a couple of new faces. And every one of them has been practicing all gear for one night. For one night of mech madness. This is what it's all about.
Midnight mech mania! Excuse me while I pick off the guy who has the most health. Or had the most health before I started shooting. If I can hit him in the center torso. Ow. Come on, you son of a bitch. Oh, damn it. See, you're not allowed to use a cover effectively like that. Stop being a good sportsman. Stand fucking still. Well, there's an arm. Ah! My kills are getting away from me! Uh-oh. This Fafnir. I'm not having a sniping match with you. I'm putting you down before you cause any trouble. It looks like, well, I'm actually not gonna walk out of here with too many kills. That's rather unfortunate.
Kapow! Boy, do we have a game. We're past halfway here and we've already knocked out some of the crowd's favorites. Srin Odessa is still in the running, and it looks like her mysterious training regimen is paying off. I hear she was eating live beetles last week. Well, whatever. She certainly still has what it takes down there. But well, Rookie Spectre looks like he is picking up her gauntlet. I wonder if those two will face each other. It's been a good match. A lot of clean kills along the way. Now we're down to our contenders for today's victor. We know who our final three are, but who's gonna be number one?
Well, it seems like our friend there was practicing running away really, really hard up until I caught up with him. Okay, so it looks like we are going to have a sniping match. It's a duel between me and the Fafnir. Well, if the Fafnir leaves us alone for 5 seconds, it looks like she will. Remove Daishi.
Target destroyed.
Well, and now we will shoot at each other repeatedly until one of us falls. Two giant towers of sniper cannons. Unfortunately, I know who will win.
I don't believe it, Spectre.
You expected someone else?
Samantha Coleman has been put down. Srin Odessa is no more. We have a new champion, and his name is Spectre. What an upset. He started as a rookie pilot in the biggest show in the Inner Sphere, and he walks away the champion of Solaris. You gotta think the line will be long to join his merc company. The city is going to be a madhouse tonight. Truly one of the greatest upsets of all time. The name Spectre may join the ranks of the Giants of Solaris. People like Kai Allard Leo, Oliver Two-Horse, and Gray Norton. He has truly left his mark. A merc from out of nowhere has won the biggest match of the year. And you were here, Solaris fans. This is Duncan Fisher, live from Solaris. Join us back shortly when we interview Spectre himself and some of the other combatants on this truly spectacular day of Solaris action.
History has been made. Well, folks, that's it. That's the end of the Solaris season. We're all done here. I suppose now it's time to ship out to greener pastures. We have our trophy, our title, and our glory, and now, well, we still need to make a living, even though, frankly, with the amount of money we have on hand here, I think we could just retire and just be done with it. Be done with this lifestyle. Frankly, I'm kind of surprised there is no Solaris ending to this game. But oh well. Well, what do we have left? I think Wurmkel is the only place we haven't actually touched. Solaris has nothing left. Hesperus, too. Alright, Hesperus 2. Where were we beforehand? We're on Halloran, right? Or Tharkad. Wait a minute. Wait! That's the ending mission! Huh. Wait a minute here. Well, I suppose before we go marauding off into the darkness over there, we'll actually finish the rest of the game here first. Gotta be a completionist, gotta get all the money. But, so let's ship off to Hesperus 2 and mop up. I'll see you all next time.